The risks shown in this short animated film may appear with every round. They arise even more often than the special complications, which are explained in our other film, and normally they don't last that long. Mostly, after removing a wisdom tooth, the patient feels pain. It lasts normally some days, and with painkillers it is easily controllable. The pain arises for irritation of the ends of the nerves in the operation wound. We try to reduce the pain by removing the bone very slowly and with less pressure. The wound healing is suspicious if obvious complaints crop up again suddenly after a painless phase of some days. A swelling of the jowl occurs almost ever, and it even intensifies until the second day after the operation. After 1 week, it has mostly already disappeared. Heat sinks may reduce the swelling, but also the pain. Actually, behind the swelling burrows a useful clearance of the body. The body must get the defending cells out of the bloodstream into the injured tissue. Then the bloodstream is slowed down and the jowl warms up. The vessels become permeable and the defending cells can get into the tissue. Together with the defending cells, also liquid penetrates into the tissue and it leads to a swelling. Finally, the subject inflammation. Normally, after having sutured the wound, it is rebuilt into new bone. But especially this area is washed around with leftovers, which might also stay in the wound. An inflammation appears classically after 3 weeks after the intervention. The hole in the bone gets pus-filled. The patient recognizes once again a swelling of the jowl and, because of the pus, a bad taste in the mouth. On the other hand, the pain is comparatively less. Normally, the treatment is easy by ensuring that there is enough outflow out of the wound. If the wounds are endangered, we always put in a tamponade immediately, which guarantees the draining off.